Okay, y'all, this is gonna be my most edited video on YouTube yet. And it's gonna be YouTube exclusive, so it's not going up on my Twitch, it's not going up on my TikTok. But it's gonna be on YouTube for y'all to watch, and I'm kind of excited about this one. I found it really interesting. I was scrolling TikTok as you do when you can't sleep, because that's clearly gonna help you get to sleep. And I came across graveyard cleaning videos. There's like a grave talk, and if you actually, you could search TikTok and type in grave talk or like grave cleaning, and it'll pull these videos up, and we're gonna go through some of them because it's wild to me. I think it's, on one hand, I think it's like good if you have like the family's permission, because like everyone deserves like a clean resting place. Like I hate it when I walk by graves and I see some that look like they're just forgotten about. Like if the family's no longer around, like I don't care if you clean, like it's fine, clean it if they're not around. I mean, like if they're like dead, if the family is dead, go ahead and clean the grave. You know, if they no longer have family, like that's great community service. I know when I was younger, I think we did community service. And we did some community service along like the railroad. There's like a walking path near the railroad, and we did like some cleaning up there. But we also went to a local cemetery and participated in cleaning graves. We did not video it because this is an elementary school, like before TikTok was even a big thing. And I have vague memories of this. And it's one of those things that after my brain injury, and my memories started to like come back, that I was like, did I actually really clean a grave as a kid? Did my school really bring us on a field trip to clean graves? And yes, they did. But I think it's wild that people are using it for money, and people are, and I will say they're using it for money, because some of these videos are getting like 744.5k views. The one I'm looking at right now in particular, I'm going to show you guys several. And it's crazy. Like, you're filming somebody's grave and cleaning it so you could get views. Now, like I said, I wouldn't care if, say, they're cleaning their own family's graveyard, or like they have the family's permission. Where I think it gets tricky is if the family is, they still have living family members and you're cleaning that grave without permission. Like, what if that was like their child buried there and you went and cleaned the grave and they went the next day? They're like, who did all this and was touching my baby's grave? Like, there's so, like, I can see it from several like perspectives. And I find it just very interesting. Like, I've never felt scared in a graveyard. Like, I feel very comfortable in graveyards. But I'm also just, I don't know, it doesn't scare me. Like, not much scares me. I don't know if I believe in the paranormal, but, like, I think if the paranormal exists, I'm open-minded. I think a lot of spirits are friendly, and the ones that aren't, you know, I don't know, just stay away from those ones. But I feel like most spirits are probably friendly, if there are spirits, you know. I'm not saying there is. I don't know. I keep it at I don't know, because I don't know what happens after we're gone from this earth. Y'all let me tell you, y'all tell me in the comments if y'all believe in the paranormal. But we're gonna skip to the first TikTok. And y'all, this to me is wild. These are wild. Let's skip to the first TikTok. Okay, so we're here to our first video. It is by Manic Pixie Mom. And I don't know, one of the first comments was, why does these graveyard cleaning videos only appear at night? That's interesting that they only appear at night. I guess it might just be when the content creator like gets home that they find the time to upload them. I don't know how many graves they clean in a day. I don't know, like, how you conveniently have the supplies in your car to clean a grave. It's all interesting to me, but, let's watch.
Died in 1874 at the age of 7. The cause of death recorded on her death record is brain fever. Brain fever was an umbrella term that could be used to describe meningitis, encephalitis, or cerebritis, basically inflammation of the brain. In Katie's time, any of these afflictions would have about a 90% mortality rate. The prognosis usually is better now, but they're still pretty deadly. Katie's parents were named Henry and Lucy Weeks. Henry worked first as a carpenter and later was a car mechanic.
Oh, so that's so sad. Don't tell me she died when her parents were still alive. Oh, good. Because it says who her parents are in it. Oh, my goodness. I hope she was not like a child when she died.
A year after Katie was born in 1868, Lucy gave birth to a little boy named Alan. Alan died just 8 days after he was born.
Is this her relative? Because, like, how does she know so much of the family history? Did she, like, go to, like, the archives in the local library? I genuinely want to know.
The cause of death recorded on his record is fits. He most likely had some underlying condition that caused seizures. Henry and Lucy also had a daughter named Edith a few years after Katie died, and she would be their only surviving child. Katie's mom, Lucy, died in 1891 at the age of 43 of pneumonia.
Watching the scrubbing is so satisfying.
At the age of 75 due to cancer. Her sister Edith lived all the way to the age of 83, dying in 1959. I'm still trying to decipher the inscription at the top of the grave, but the one at the bottom reads, "Hers the little hand that beckons, over from the radiant shore, angel of the Lord to lead us, there we'll never love her more."
The difference is so, it is incredible, like how black and like mossy it was to like when it's cleaned, like it does look a lot like better. And I'm guessing the family is long gone. So like this one, I don't have an issue with because like who else is going to clean it? I feel like she's just doing like a good service to the community, but like she really went and like looked into the family history, which is very interesting to me. I mean, maybe she went through like genealogy records, on one hand, like it's cool to learn that information. Like I always wonder how people like from the 1800s lived and passed and things like that. And I like the information she gave us on the diseases that are now treatable that weren't then. However, I feel like that's like something that might be very like, I don't know. Like, I feel like the way somebody died is very like that's the family's personal information. Maybe it's just me living in Maine, but I was raised, you know, you mind your own business. And Maine's a very friendly, has a very friendly community. Like, but I don't go digging into other people's family and their history and things like that. Like, unless I know the person and I'm getting to know them, like I might be dating them, then I might ask questions about like your family or, you know, if we know someone in common, we might talk. But I'm very much a mind your own business. Like, I don't know if I would go through genealogy records from somebody else's family to tell the story, but great on her because it was such an informative video. And the grave does look better. So, yeah, let's find another one. Let's watch more graves get cleaned. I never thought I'd say that in my life. But it is very satisfying to see the difference and see them, like, scrubbing and everything. Okay, so we're on to the next one. This is called the_the_clean_girl. And it says, cleaning a baby's grave for free. It got 1.9 million views. So, I don't think it's for free. I think you're making a little bit of money off TikTok, if you know what I mean. And I've heard her, I've seen some of her other videos, and, like, one of them, she, like, shows, like, one of her products just casually, like, in the corner. I didn't go and find that specific video, but it showed one of her, like, cleaning products in the corner, and the camera was conveniently angled to show it. And then in another, she held up, like, a sponge, and she had hashtag, like, a partnership underneath it. So I don't think it's a for free. Like, I really... I'm very skeptical about that, but,
a baby was buried here today.
Oh, that is not the way to start any video. A baby was buried here. What the? Is that how we're starting off this video?
I'm going to clean his grave for free. Immediately, my mind filled with so many questions. What happened? What was their life like? What kind of pain did this family go through? This was extremely hard for me, but I knew I had
to- Okay, why are you making it about you? This is about you. You're cleaning this poor baby's grave, and it looks like the baby died in, like, 79, 4/22/79. And, like, I feel like I have those same questions, too, but you shouldn't be like, this is hard for me, because you're very much making it about you. Like, this is literally somebody's dead relative or dead ancestor, and you're over here like, this is hard for me. You chose to go and clean the grave. Like, I'm sorry. Like, even the comment says not, like, the top comments is not making this about you. Eek. And that's my first thought, too. So great minds think alike. This is what was their like. It obviously wasn't that long, is another comment, considering they were born in 79 and they died in 79, which is really, really tragic.
Honor baby David by transforming his final resting place. Baby David was born on April 10th, and he passed away just 12 days later on April 22nd.
That's a very short life. Oh, I didn't even notice, like, the 10 and the 22. That is tragic. No parent should have to go through that. Oh, good. Like, my aunt lost my nephew when he was, like, very, very... He was like a young man, but he was an adult. But even to this day, it is very hard for her to cope with. Like, no parent should have to see their baby or child leave this world before them. Because that's very traumatic.
Mother's name was Nellie. As I was cleaning, I couldn't help but think about her. A sadness came over me. And then a bit of anger. Why wasn't this baby given a chance at life? I can't imagine the pain that Nellie suffered after losing her baby boy. I really hope she eventually found her peace. I don't know if David has any remaining family still alive, but I know how hard it can be to visit the grave of someone you love. I'm so happy that I can do this for families, and I'm grateful for each and every one of you who follows and supports me to do these transformations.
I hope that poor baby doesn't have siblings that are still alive, because, what, 79, it's 2024, one would make it 80, they'd be, like, 54, and imagine them showing up to their siblings' grave that their mother traumatically lost only 12 days later, and it looks different from how you left it. Like, I feel like that's something you should get the family's permission for. Is that just me? I almost think it's, like, very disrespectful to the family. It's also, like, kind of sad that the grave is left the way it is also. So, like, I don't know. By the way, would you guys like to see, my grandmother goes to fix the cemetery, likes to go yearly, and my mother goes and helps her, and sometimes I do, and, she likes to spruce up the family cemetery. Would y'all like, to see, like, some videos over on my TikTok cleaning up my family cemetery and everything? Because, like, in talking about some of the family history, because I think that'd be really cool, like, if it was your actual family member's grave, because I see nothing wrong with sprucing up your family member's grave. So let me know if you want to do that, because, like, I've always wanted to pick my grandmother's for information about, like, the family history from, like, my papa's side to my nana's side. So let me know if that's something you want to do, because that could be fun. Like, these are satisfying videos to watch. I just wish instead of cleaning a stranger's family member's grave, they were cleaning their own family member's grave or somebody they had permission from to do it. Because I think you got to be sensitive when it comes to people's losses. Okay, so she has another video. It says what happened to her, and I am very curious. An abandoned grave. Okay. How did she just conveniently have a chainsaw in her car? Is nobody else in the... I gotta see if anyone else in the comment section is asking that. Because, like, that was gonna be my question. Like, like, nobody's asking how she just conveniently had a chainsaw when she found this abandoned grave.
If it ain't for free, I have no idea who's buried.
2.6 million views. I don't think this is for free, lady. I'm sorry. I feel like your videos might be monetized.
Oh my gosh, you guys. This grave is huge.
She conveniently has a rake and a shovel, too. What is her pastime? Chainsaw, rake, and shovel. I've watched enough true crime videos that that's concerning if somebody has all of those and cleaning supplies in their car. Like, if a friend of mine were to pick me up and I look in the back and they got, like, a rake that's pointy with a shovel, with a chainsaw, with some cleaning supplies, I'm gonna ask... first, I'm gonna get out of the car, and then I'm gonna ask what they've been doing. Like, are they hiding a body? Like, those are some odd things to just be in a car together. I don't know. Like, I'm not asking questions. Maybe they were in the trunk. So, like, maybe nobody getting in her car notices that she's got all this stuff, but I feel like it would be weird to get, like, pulled over by a cop, and they're like, yeah, so, do you know what you got pulled over for? You were speeding, and then, like, say, and then there's, like, a chainsaw in the back seat. I feel like they're gonna have more questions for you, as some cleaning supplies,
I just think I'm hovering more and more. My mind is swirling with questions. How did all this get so buried?
I mean, maybe she died a long time ago. Like, trees and bushes grow. Like, I feel like how she got buried is pretty obvious. Like, the trees grew. Maybe it wasn't tended to. Maybe the family's gone. Maybe the woman didn't have any friends or family. Who knows? But, like, clearly it's just been left there for a while and the plants naturally grew over it. And maybe the family even planted the trees on top of there because, like, there are people who plant flowers to grow over their loved one's grave on purpose. Like, I know somebody who said they wanted to be cremated and have their ashes be used, like, under to plant, like, an apple tree. So, like, people have different things that, like, when they want to be buried, what they want to happen. Like, me, I want to be cremated. I want half of my ashes in the family cemetery next to my Nana, and I want the other half buried at my childhood home, which you have to get a permit to do where I live, but you can actually bury someone in your backyard legally, as long as they died naturally, I should say. Well, as long as... Let me rephrase that. You didn't murder him. Like, you can't just murder somebody and bury them in the backyard and be like, hey, I need a permit. People might have some questions for you there, but you can say, you know, my loved one died. Can I get a permit? I want to bury them at the house. That was their, like, wishes. So you can get a permit, turns out. And I only found out because my grandmother was, like, at the town office or something with my mother sorting out some deeds to my some graveyards that my grandmother owned, and it turns out the town apparently wasn't giving out, like, how do I put this, they weren't keeping proper track of who they sold burial plots to, and people were getting buried in plots without permission. So my grandmother was then interviewed by, like, the newspaper, a true story, and whatnot, because she had to, like, fight with the city to get graves that we already owned, yeah, that's, like, a whole big story on its own. I'm gonna have to find a newspaper article somewhere, but, I was like, wow, Grammy, you go, uncovering a graveyard scandal, literally. But she was joking around with the lady at the deed office or wherever it was. And she, my mom and my nan, and they were telling her, I always jokingly said I want to be buried at my mother's house when I go. And the lady was like, you can do that with a permit. And I was like, okay, that's how I'm being buried. Like, my wishes are, you know, and everybody in my family knows I say this constantly. And now it's not a joke anymore. Now I'm serious. Like, bury me in my mother's backyard. but yeah, so. After a whole day of cleaning, I could find. I want to know what the pink stuff she's spraying is.
The name, Doris Lugo. But we're only just starting to uncover her mystery. I know Doris was born August.
Thing girl. Okay. Yep. She her own product. Yep. Definitely not making this video to promote your own product.
1845, and she passed away February 1st.
I mean, I will say it looks like the product works really well. To be fair, like. That grave was awful dirty, and now it's, like, very clean looking very quickly.
95. But who put Doris in the forest? I kept wondering what her life was like. Who did she love? Was she pretty? Did she have a dog? I tried to find more information online, and I found nothing. That made me so sad. I can't stand the thought of Doris disappearing into the forest, being forgotten forever. Making her corner of the world beautiful again is the least I can do. I'm so grateful to everyone who follows me to do these transformations.
Okay, that looks really pretty at the end. I got to admit, like, I want to almost, like, hate on these videos because I feel like it's so disrespectful to go to somebody's random grave and, like, start cleaning it and everything. But, like, that does look pretty at the end, to be honest. You know? Like, but I feel like she should be honest. Like, I am making money off this. Like, this is not for free. You're not just doing this to be a good person. Or maybe it is, but she's still making money on the side either way because she's posting it on TikTok. Like, I feel like that might be a sign that you're not doing it for free. I don't know. Don't come at me, but, like, I'm just saying. Okay, so I found our next video. It's by Grace Good.
I found an old grave on dead grass. I decided to clean it as best I could. The grave was very old, and I was curious to see what it belonged to.
She's standing on somebody's grave, and I'ma be honest, I kind of feel like that might be disrespectful, and I don't think I'm wrong, because somebody in the comments also said it's really disrespectful to stand on top of somebody's grave. Like, it's very kind to stop and, like, clean the dead grass off the grave. Like, that's very nice of you. Maybe if you weren't, like,
cleaning the kid's grave.
Maybe if you weren't, sorry, like, we went on a whole different video, but, like, maybe if you weren't, like, posting it on TikTok, but it really seems like people, like, are they doing, I have to question, are you doing it for, like, from, like, the good of your heart, or to get views, like, and I feel like the voice definitely isn't hers, or his, it's very, very deep, and I think it's a woman cleaning it, I'm not sure, it looks like a woman in the profile picture, but I don't want to assume somebody's gender identity. But yeah. This is grave covering decorating. I hope this is their grave. I hope this is a family grave. They're decorating it for Christmas. That looks really cool. That looks really, really cool. This is Flowers for Angels 7. That looks really nice. That's, like, a great idea for, like, you know, to do at your own family cemetery. Like, around Christmas. Where I live, you can't really do that because it snows in Christmas. But, like, if it's warm where you live, that's kind of a cool idea. But also, I really hope that is a family grave, because it would be very weird if somebody showed up to the graveyard to mourn, and you're like, why are there candy canes and rocks and bricks on my loved one's grave? that would be, like, strange for me. But let me know what you think about graveyard cleaning on TikTok and grave talk. You can search either of those to find these grave cleaning videos. I can only feature so many without this video becoming super, super long. But I'd like to know your thoughts on it. Do you think it's, like, a good community service? Do you think posting the videos could be seen as disrespectful? Do you share, like, the same views as I do that, like, you should get the family's permission first if there's living family and friends? Do you feel like digging into the family history and telling that along with cleaning the graves is all right if it's not your family member? Like, I'm curious as to y'all's views. I found it so interesting, and I was very, like, I was mesmerized once I found out there was a grave talk. I posted on Facebook a conversation I had with my mom where I was literally like, do you want to go clean the family graves? And my mom was like, what? And I was like, cleaning graves is now a TikTok trend. And my mother was like, are you serious? And I was like, yeah, I can send you the videos. And I'm sure Grammy would love to hop on down to the cemetery because my grandmother enjoys planting flowers in the summer and, like, sprucing up the graveyard, pulling up weeds and stuff. Like, that graveyard is her hobby. It sounds weird when you call it a hobby because it sounds like, it makes her sound like she's, like, some, like, filling the graveyard is her hobby. That is not. Decorating the graveyard is her hobby of, you know, the family members. My grandmother likes going there weeding, planting flowers, you know, making it look nice and pretty, and everything. You know, putting little decorations and everything. She doesn't, you know, like, her hobby isn't filling the graveyard. Anyways, I'm gonna go. I hope y'all are having a lovely, lovely day. And I will see you all another day.